You know, one of the big pieces of drama, and normally we avoid all the TMZ garbage around here, but I mean, when it actually affects and has an impact on the movies that we're going to see, it's worth talking about. Now, we know Dwayne The Rock Johnson, also known as Franchise Viagra, came into the Fast and Furious franchise, and it's not coincidental that the box office started to shoot up, you know, three times when it did. Now, for a long time, that was great. But then we started to hear about some behind-the-scenes drama going on between Vin Diesel and Dwayne The Rock Johnson that started to blow up quite badly. Now, at first, a lot of people, admittedly including me, thought it was all a publicity stunt. You know, oh, they're feuding. Oh, so now we're going to get a Fast and Furious movie where it's them, you know, it's Hobbs against Vin. And it turns out it wasn't. And actually, you know, as Dwayne Johnson started to explain the situation more, it really became apparent that these two guys could not get along. Now, recently, you know, the two of them kind of extended some olive branches over social media, like expressing one well wishes to the wedding and the other said, thank you very much. And maybe it looked like things were starting to calm down. And maybe, just maybe, we could see Dwayne The Rock Johnson get back involved in the Fast and Furious proper movies. Well, too bad. That ain't going to happen, apparently. This comes to us from the folks over at Complex that I was reading this on. But basically what happened is this. In a recent interview, Vin Diesel decided, and you guys know I'm a big Vin Diesel fan. I love Vin Diesel. But he did something that was probably ill-advised. While being interviewed, he basically said something along the lines of, yeah, you know, in order for me as a producer to get the best performance possible out of my crew and out of my actors, I sometimes had to, you know, institute tough love is the phrase he used, tough love. And I don't apologize for that because I need to get the best performance out of my producers. To which Dwayne The Rock Johnson was just at an event with Emily Blunt promoting, of course, the upcoming Jungle Cruise. And Dwayne Johnson reacted to that. And he basically says, he's decided not to go too much into it, but he basically said, yeah, we just laughed a lot at that. This is what he said. He says, I laughed and I laughed hard, Johnson said, when asked about the comments that Vin Diesel made, per the Hollywood Reporter's Rebecca Keegan, who's a friend of mine. I think everyone had a laugh at that. And I'll leave it at that. And that I've wished them well. I wish them well for Fast 9. I will wish them well and best of luck on Fast 10 and Fast 11 and the rest of the Fast and the Furious movies that they will do, but it'll be without me. So if there was any hopes that I had kind of talked about and expressed, guys, that maybe we could see a reconciliation here, we could see Vin and The Rock back on screen in an actual Fast and the Furious movie, and I assume Dwayne Johnson isn't talking about Hobbs and Shaw. I'm assuming he's still going to do his Hobbs and Shaw too, which won't have Vin Diesel in it. But it seems like that's done. And that's unfortunate because I was really starting to think we might see Dwayne Johnson back in Fast 10. Apparently not. Greg, I know we were talking about this just briefly before the show started. Were you thinking we were going to see The Rock back? Did you never think we were going to see him back? And what do you make of these comments?
You know, you told me about this right before we went live, and my mind's sort of just been spiraling. I don't care about any other topics today now, John. This is the only thing that matters to me. I mean, one thing that pops into my mind is you know, when I saw this last F9 movie, I really felt the film was weighed down by Vin Diesel's insistency on making sure that's like so much drama and gravitas. And I'm wondering if any of what Vin Diesel said is actually true about trying to bring out the best in his actors, and if trying to pull some dramatic antics weighed down him working with The Rock the way how it weighs down how the Fast and Furious franchise is ultimately progressing. I don't like the idea of The Rock not returning because it's weird to me how before I saw F9, I was thinking it's probably not a big deal that Dwayne Johnson's not in this movie. I don't feel like he needs to be in it. And then when I was watching the film halfway through, it really hit me like during my actual viewing experience of how much of a necessity the presence of Dwayne Johnson actually is for the Fast and Furious franchise to help balance out the kind of energy that needs to remain consistent throughout the film when there's not a bunch of crazy action going on. I think that's something that Dwayne Johnson brings remarkably well, is he can have a sense of energy that keeps the film feeling alive and pulsating. Whereas like F9, when there wasn't action, it just felt like a kind of a slog of a dramatic mess. And so I don't like the idea of Dwayne Johnson not returning. However, I mean, it still could be the wrestling feud that a lot of us were speculating on, because it's kind of a weird thing to think about, of how you'll have these two existing franchises, Fast and Furious and Hobbs and Shaw.
Yeah.
But where the public is going to be aware that the two leads don't get along. And I'm wondering, like, what if this actually does build up hype to want to see them cross back over together again in like Fast 11 or something like
that?
So
you're thinking this still could be a play. This could still be all drama, fake drama. This is all an act they're putting on to build up.
They got two wrestlers in the franchise now. Yeah, they got John Cena and Dwayne Johnson. So I feel like they're maybe possibly, it's a big possibility that they are infusing some of that wrestling quality into it to make it that much more exciting for the audience. That's my hope.
If they are, they sure are playing a long game, because this has been going on for years. Rob, what about you? Were you expecting to see Dwayne Johnson back? Do you think the series even needs him back? What do you think about this latest drama? What are your thoughts on this?
Well, you know, I did have such love for the Fast and Furious franchise until Fast 9. But, you know, sometimes people stumble and fall, and I think the franchise can pick itself back up. But I think it needs Dwayne Johnson. Greg's got a good point here. You got two wrestlers. What better way? I mean, Dwayne Johnson is not a man. He's not just going after Vin Diesel. He's going after Universal. You know, and Universal has made a lot of money with the Fast and the Furious movies that have Dwayne Johnson in them, beginning with the Citizen Kane of that franchise, Fast 5. And I think that... I think that Dwayne Johnson is a company man. He's a player. I don't think there's any harder working man in show business in terms of protecting his franchises and doing the publicity work. And the fact that we are talking about this right now proves how effective perhaps this approach is. And my God, they're building a marketing campaign maybe 2 or 3 years out. Can you imagine the poster, the key art with Dwayne The Rock Johnson and Vin Diesel head to head? You know, Hobbs comes back and he's and hell comes with him or something.
Hobbs and make that shirt. Hobbs comes back and hell comes with him.
Yeah,
there it is.
I think that this is actually kind of fun. At first I was like, ooh, but now I'm thinking, you know what? The publicity train is going. They'll probably shoot these last two movies back to back, and what a great way to start building hype for the next part of this franchise.
All right, the question is for you guys: what do you think about this latest page in the book of drama that is the Vin Diesel Dwayne The Rock Johnson feud? Do you think it's all just an act? I did at one point. I think it's too long of a game for it to be that at this point. Anyway, guys, what do you think about it? Jump on down into the comment section below and let us know your thoughts. Okay, guys.